Hi there, welcome to Big V TV. Great to have you with us. Division 1 men and three rounds in. I'm thinking that this could be the most and closest exciting men's competition, senior competition in the Big V this season.
Yeah, I think it's going to be, being involved, you can see every week you're coming up against a team where you know it's going to be a tough game. It's not going to be a walk in the park.
Yep.
And even at the ones at the top, you know if you're playing well, you can get them. So, I think it's a really balanced division this year.
No doubt. Let's have a look at the results from round three. Warrandyte 44, shot at 22%.
Yeah.
Casey 75. Dean Johnson, great to see Jono. 14 and 14. Good double-double there. I think Lester Strong came off the bench. I reckon Brent Reed, the coach, Stretch, he would have done one of two things after that game. One of two things. Knowing what Stretch is like, one of two things. He would have either walked into the change rooms,
mm-hmm.
grabbed his bag, and said, "See you Tuesday." Or he would have absolutely ripped them a new one like there's no tomorrow. I reckon guys would have been jumping in the Yarra if he had ripped them.
What would you have preferred? If you were a player,
when you shoot at 22%,
would you rather be ripped into then, or just knowing the coach has walked out in disgust?
Well, you answer it from a player's perspective. I'll answer it from a coach's perspective.
I'd probably prefer him just to leave and let's chat about it Tuesday.
Because
ranting and raving might not necessarily change anything from that game.
From a coaching perspective, I would have grabbed my bag and said, "Fellas, see you Tuesday." You shoot at 22%. You've held Casey, who are a very good team, to 75.
Yeah.
You've had a shocking night shooting. You know what? Sometimes you just have those days. Grab your stuff, get out of there. Let's reload on Tuesday and get on with it. It's done. Can't do anything about it. Keel, good to see we're on the same page there, Jeffo. You and I might make a good team one day. Keelor 81 went down to Sunbury 85. Caban 26 and 8 for Keelor. Ish Sanders 28 for Sunbury. And Mitch Newton 28 and 14. Now, I saw Mitch Newton during the tournament. I like him.
Yeah, he's big. He's athletic. He can shoot from outside. So he's definitely hard to guard.
Great work ethic too.
Yeah.
Just gets up and down the floor.
Tries to dunk it virtually every time he goes up for a layup.
Yep, like him. As Jeffo does, by the way. Tries to dunk it every time he goes up for a layup.
Hits the net.
Just brushes the bottom of it. Sunbury will be very, very relieved to get that one, I think.
Well, yeah, there was 81 free throws in this game as well. So, and 52 of those were actually to Sunbury. So, I think...
52? They went to the charity... 52 times.
On the road.
Of the 81.
So they had the
Jake. Keelor had about four people found out.
The Jayco caravan was set up.
Yes. Yeah.
Gee.
And that was obviously the difference, as it's only 4 points and they had about 30 extra free throws.
Mate, when the Sunbury coach said to Ish, "Go and collect some firewood. We're setting up a camp at the Cherry Stripe." He wasn't joking, was he? Mildura 53 went down to Chelsea 90. Or we should probably say, no disrespect to every other goals player, but they went down to Corey Standerfer. 33 points, 16 rebounds, 8 assists. You're talking early MVP candidates. Standerfer keeps putting up those numbers this season. Wow.
Yeah. We thought he had a good year last year. And now I think he's just taken up a notch again.
I agree.
Big
win for Chelsea. It can't be underestimated. The loss of Calvin Henry on the eve of the season for Mildura is a bitter, bitter blow.
Look, massive loss. I'm not sure whether Calvin Henry would have, overturned that result. I think Chelsea were locked in from the beginning, but certainly margins-wise, he'd make a big, big difference.
Melbourne Uni 44 went down to Shepparton 63. No player in double digits for Melbourne Uni. It's not a good sign. It's not a good sign at all. Shepparton, Reggie Fuller had 15 and 15. I reckon Mildura wouldn't mind having Reggie back up there at the moment. Keysborough 91. Dave Smith had 18. Geelong 107. Way to bounce back the Supercats. They went down to Camberwell the week before. Terrence Motley, who is a beast, by the way. He is an absolute giant. 28 and 13. Very good game from him. Geelong 107 on the rebound. Great.
Yeah, well, Motley, he'll be an MVP candidate, that's for sure. He's a beast. He's really important to that Geelong side, as he's their main big guy.
Yeah.
he's their go-to guy. So a huge win for them. I think Keyes were undefeated going into this week. So
Keyes have been good so far, and they've scored 91. It's not often you're going to score 91 in this comp and lose a game of basketball, so they can be well pleased with that. I think Dane Bowe stepped up for some points as well for Geelong. Blackburn 92 defeated Latrobe City 67. Nick George, great to see him running around. He had that serious injury a couple of years ago. 20 points. Jordan Coleman 28 of Latrobe 67. He's an import down there at the moment. He's flying the flag by himself.
I was going to say the same thing. He's pretty much doing it all on his own. You speak about MVP candidates early on in the season. He's the most valuable player to his team by a country mile.
And the final one, Camberwell 73 went down to Warrnambool 84. Sobey had 25. Xavier Blount. Is it Blount? Is he French? Did you have a chat to him during the game?
I think it's Aussie. It's just Blount.
Oh, Blount, is it? Xavier Blount had 20 points. 48-34 second half by Warrnambool. So you guys were right with him in the first half.
Yeah, well, it was for three quarters we were with him. It was just the last quarter. We started the quarter pretty even. They snuck away. I think the last quarter was 24-15.
Yeah.
Sobey stepped up, hit a couple of tough shots.
You guys down a couple of plays too.
Yeah.
But injury concerns.
Yeah, we've got a few injury concerns, but we don't use that as an excuse. We had a chance to win that yesterday.
Straight out of the Arnold Gifting coaching book, that one. Ladder, Shepparton 3 and Zip. Only unbeaten team, that's what I'm saying. There's only one unbeaten team and one team without a win. That's how close it is.
Pretty tight.
Shepparton 3 and Zip, Casey Geelong 3 and 1, Blackburn, Keilor, Keysborough, Warrnambool 2 and 1, Warrandyte 2 and 2. Chelsea, Camberwell, Sunbury, Melton, Latrobe, all 1-2. Mildura 1-3, Melbourne Uni, I think it's going to be a long season, are Zip and 4. Round 4 and lots of games on the menu. Here we go, Saturday, Geelong, Melbourne Uni, give me the Supercats.
Supercats.
Comfortably, yeah.
Sunbury, Latrobe, I'm going with Mitch and Ish.
Yep.
Yeah, first Sunbury statement as well.
Casey take on Camberwell, Steve-O.
Casey have been pretty strong this year. I'd probably go with the home side.
I think Casey at home might be a little bit too strong for
definitely
the
Dragons for me.
Melton take on Keilor.
Melton had the week off.
And Melton are 1-2, by the way, so they're going to want to bounce back here. It's a big difference. Melton, if Melton lose, they go 1-3. Keilor go 3-1.
Yeah.
It's a big difference. It really is a key game for both these teams.
Big gap. Yeah, I'm going to say Melton, yeah.
I reckon Melton might get it at home.
Oh, I think the thoroughbreds, yeah.
Yeah, okay, geez, we're all going for them. All right, no worries. Mildura take on Shepparton. I'm going the Gators on the road.
Yep.
Gators all round?
Yeah, Gators.
Last one on Saturday night, Warrandyte and Warrnambool. Based on what I saw from Warrandyte last week, if they don't pull their socks up shooting-wise, they might be in a bit of strife here. I'm going to go for the Seahawks on the road.
I actually think Warrandyte will defend. Matchup-wise, they'll match up all right against Warrnambool.
Who goes to Sobey?
They've got a couple of guys. Mitch Hawley can guard
pretty much you're right. Yeah, it's a good call. Good call.
But I think Warrnambool will be tougher.
Here he goes. He's going the upset here.
Yeah, I'm going to say Warrandyte.
I can see it in your eyes every time you do that.
Bounce back.
Sunday, Latrobe take on Melton down at Latrobe. I think Melton might get 2 from 2.
Yeah, it'd be a good weekend for them, actually, to bounce back and grab 2 wins, Melton for me.
Yeah, Melton.
Chelsea take on Sunbury. Good game. Probably game of the round. I think Sunbury start favourites at home, but I love the form of Ish Sanders and Mitch Newton last week. I said Chelsea at home.
Oh, I thought you said Sunbury start favourites.
Sorry, Chelsea at home. Chelsea to win for me.
Oh, it's a tough one, but I'll probably go Chelsea standard for...
I don't think Sunbury will be taking 50 free throws again, so I'm going to go with Chelsea.
Melbourne Uni Blackburn, like what Blackburn's doing at the moment.
Yeah, Blackie will get that one.
Yep.
Good team down there at Blackburn. And Keilor take on Keysborough. Who are you going for?
Ooh, that's a toughie. I'm going to...
Don't look at the ladder, just give me a result.
No, I was trying to look at last week's results. I'm going to go with... Keysborough.
I'm going to go Keysborough as well. Not often you'll score 91 in a game and lose.
Yeah, I'm going to go Keilor at home.
Okay, there we go. D1 men. As you can see, it is so hard tipping winners in D1 men. That's how close it is. Good games every week without doubt in D1 men. Get out there and support your teams. We'll see you next week on Big VTV.